Recently, a few of us sixth graders attended a LabVIEW Architects meeting here in sometimes too sunny Austin, Texas. The presenters briefly discussed the Suspend When Called option in SubVI Node Setup. Jaws dropped as, almost to a person, we realized that we hadn't been fully utilizing this important feature. Let's explore. This very simple VI takes two numbers, numeric and numeric 2, and multiplies them in this sub-VI, featuring an iconically clever play on words. We're just multiplying them together, and then checks to see if that product passes a threshold value of 10. To check this, I'll put a 2 and a 3 in the front panel numerics, run the VI. We have an output of 6, which does not pass the threshold value of 10, and so our LED stays off. If I right-click on the sub-VI, I bring up the sub-VI node setup. I'll click on Suspend When Called, OK. Now, when I run the VI, the front panel of the sub-VI comes up and allows me to interact. I can, for instance, change the value of the incoming data, run the sub-VI again, and so now I can essentially supply whatever data I want to the sub-VI, regardless of what my calling VI actually supplied. So I'll click on Return to Caller, and the VI stops. Additionally, and I hope you're sitting down, if I run this again, I can place a new value in the output of the sub-VI, regardless of what the sub-VI actually did. So for instance, right now we have a 16, which has passed the threshold, and instead I'll put a 9, return to caller, and we see that the value has not passed the threshold. This is extremely valuable if you have code reading from many sensors or test points, and let's say I want a certain shutdown procedure to occur if a temperature surpasses a threshold value, or I want additional analysis if my device under test outputs a certain waveform. Rather than actually having to run the hardware and try to recreate those scenarios, I can simply have the sub-VI that calls those sensors output the value I want. Okay, you can stand back up and cheer.